What would you say if I told you there was a company in California that wants to sell you a Glock for $2,000, when right now you can walk into any Academy Sports and Outdoors and buy a Glock for less than $500? Yeah, I'm sure a good number of people would tell me to go F myself, but there would also be a part of yourself that couldn't resist wondering, what exactly does a $2,000 Glock look like? Well, if you follow me on Instagram, Google+, or my Facebook page, you probably already know. For those of you that don't, here's what a $2,000 Glock looks like. And now, I'll politely go and F myself. Or, if you'd like, I can finish this review. The first thing everyone notices on my Tier 1 Salient Arms RTF Glock 19 is the Trinidad James inspired all gold everything barrel. Like the gold buckles on a pair of Giuseppe sneakers, the gold barrel on the Glock is the most polarizing feature. Here's the thing. The barrel isn't simply painted gold for the sake of shock value. It's the natural result of a coating process called TIN, or titanium nitride if you want to get all nerdy about it. TIN coating is used to harden and protect cutting and sliding surfaces, i.e. improves the life of your barrel while increasing its lubricity properties, all the while adding a level of bling which I personally like, but ain't for everyone. But fear not, you anti-bling tactical nuns. You can get the barrel coated in different colors as well. Seeing the gold barrel poking out from behind the window cuts on the left, right, and top of the slide remind me of a BMW M6 fitted with carbon ceramic brakes in place of the steel rotors that come standard. Like the Salient Glock, you can easily tell which M6 has the ceramic brakes by the big gold calipers poking out from behind the spokes of the wheels. These window cuts noticeably reduce the weight of the gun, which is great for concealed carry. The window cuts also change the recoil sensation of the gun, as they cause the slide to track faster than a stock Glock. And I really like it because your sights get back on target much faster. I'm personally a fan of fiber optic sights, so I'm glad they came on my gun. My eyes pick up the sights faster and I shoot more accurately, as the sights don't try to cover up the entire target when I'm shooting. The angled front slide serrations balance out the look of the slide, in my opinion, but they also make it easy to do press checks to verify that your gun is actually loaded. Before my gun underwent the Salient Arms makeover, it was a Glock 19 RTF2 with the fish scale serrations that I loved, so I told them not to touch them and leave them be. I feel it gives the gun a more unique look. Like this gun needs any more uniqueness already. Velvet. That's what I think when I see the grip and framework Salient does to its guns. The stipple job is aggressive, but still manages to be velvety smooth, so it's not ripping holes in your shirt like you live in a house full of clothes moths. They also undercut the trigger guard at the front strap and underneath the trigger to allow for a higher grip on the pistol. They also do a comic cut around the magazine release button, so it's easier to reach and more positive to engage the actual magazine release. Ever notice on the Glocks how you get this loose lockup between the barrel and the slide? In order to eliminate this and make the gun more accurate, Salient fits their Tier 1 package Glocks with a custom barrel, which is bigger than the stock barrel, but is cut down to fit perfectly in the barrel and slide lockup. Salient replaces the stock pins with stainless 416 heat treated steel, which is slightly oversized to have a tighter fit. They also replace the stock guide rod with an ISMI stainless guide rod and recoil spring. When it comes to the trigger, I can easily sum it up with this. It's like walking into your apartment only to find Rihanna sitting on your couch playing Battlefield 4 wearing one of your favorite t-shirts and nothing else. Yes, it's that good. This is a custom trigger in its purest form. There's almost no take up and there's essentially no over travel. If you want more take up, you can have more take up. They can tune it any way you'd like your trigger to be. If you don't like the flat face, you can get it curved. The beautiful thing is all of the OEM safeties are still a part of the trigger, like the plunger and drop safety. The wall is definable and the trigger breaks really clean. The reset is short and very audible and tactile. This trigger is fast. The lack of take up really allows you to get on the gun and make it sing. As a matter of fact, everything about this gun is fast. From the trigger to the transitioning from target to target, this gun is a damn athlete. It's also an accurate gun. Is it more accurate than a stock Glock? Well, I'll say this. It's damn sure easier to shoot accurately with the Salient than it would be with the stock Glock. The Salient Arms Glock is the sum of all its parts experience. On paper, it's hard to justify the price tag from a practical standpoint. But once you've experienced it, you begin to understand it. It's a totally different gun with a totally different experience. A Mustang GT and Shelby Cobra are the same cars, but then again, they're not. The same way a Glock and a Salient Arms Glock are the same, but not. I love this gun. It's easily in my top five. It's not for everyone. Hell, it's not for half of everyone. But for the people that own them, they understand how some of all of its parts come together and make for a truly intangible experience that can't be quantified. A stock Glock will never feel this special, and to me, that makes it worth it. I'm currently putting this gun through its paces to see exactly where it'll start to die on me. And this is why the gun is so dirty in the video. So far, I feel confident enough to carry this gun concealed in its current state. But I'll be doing a reliability follow-up after I try to kill it some more.